Thank you very much for inviting me to speak here. So today, so I'm going to talk about a joint work with Ed Rapid and Cheng Mao. On some representation theory of periodic groups. So let me fix some setup. So F is a local field of characteristics zero. And I need a group, so the ball G is a reactive group over F, reactive connected algebraic group over F. I'm going to consider the representation of the rational point of G. So the usual G is the FL point of G, and take a representation of this G, reduce the representation of G. Okay? And what I'm to do is to study the invariant of pi in terms of classification. So I give an example and some motivating example first. So let me take F to be a real field and let G be a compact integer group. Then you know that the set of irreducible representation G is classified by the highest weight. This is the set of irreducible representation G. Which is bijectively correspond to the set of highest weight. And in the case of integers, this is just an n-tuple of integers. Satisfying this decreasing condition. And of course, this is a map sending a pi to the highest root of pi. Okay, so in other words, the right hand side classifies the set of representation of this integer. And what I'm to do is this, to describe some invariant of this representation in terms of the right-hand side. Well, and in this case, so since G is compact, so every irreducible representation of finite dimension. So maybe the dimension of representation is a kind of basic invariant of representation. And you know that while dimensional formula gives the answer of this. So namely, so we know that the dimension of pi is expressed in terms of the highest weight of pi. And in this case, it can be very explicit. In the following way, so I plus j, I should write plus j minus I divided by j minus I. So this is an expression of the invariant representation in terms of classification. And what I have to do is to generate this, maybe for the PID case. First of all, before considering this, so we need a classification of the set of representation. So there are several setups in the PIC case, but in my talk, so I'd like to use local random correspondence as a classification. Actually, so I think this is a representation theoretic view of the local random correspondence. Is Okay, I have another comment that if G is non-compact, then of course the pi is not necessarily finite dimension. But there is a natural generalization of the dimensional representation even when G is non-compact. And so this is called the formal degree, which is in my title of the talk. So let me recall the definition of formal degree. And for simplicity, let me assume that G is semi-simple and split over F. This is just for simplicity. And take an irreducible representation. Then I have a pairing between pi and pi contour gradient. So this is G invariant pairing. Which is unique up to scaling, so I fix the choice. Unfortunately, I cannot define a generalization of dimension for all representation. I mean, I have to put some condition on pi, which is the square integrability of the representation. So I say that pi is square integrable. If all metric coefficients of pi is in L2. So metric coefficients are function on G, so it makes sense to talk if it's L2 or not. So more explicitly, pi is square integrable if and only if the function sending G to this pairing. So this is a function G is L2 for all B in pi and B check B prime in pi contour gradient. Then if pi is a square integral, so I can define a generalization of dimensional representation by using Schur orthomalization. And what is that? So if pi is square integral, then there is some positive real number. Depending on choice of a whole measure on G, such that the following integral because I'm assuming that pi is square integral, so this converges absolutely. And the claim is that so this integral is equal to the scalar multiple of this pairing W and V prime, right? For V W is in pi and V prime W prime is in pi contour gradient. And this is called Schur orthogonality relation. And so this is the equality fit you learned in the course of representation theory. Meaning that if G is compact, if G is finite, then and if the measure is normal so that the volume is 1. So this d pi is just a dimension. So in this sense, so this d pi is a generalization of dimension. And so what I want to do is to describe this d pi in terms of local Lagrange correspondence. But so you see that so I have to choose a power measure. But because I'm assuming that this d is split over f, so there is an easy choice of power measure given by the following. So to define a power measure on g, so I need a differential form on g of top degree. But because g is split, so I have a Chevalier basis of g. Or more precisely, so the Chevalier basis of the real zero g, which gives me some differential form of top degree on g. This space is one dimensional, and if I fix the Hall measure on f, then this omega determines the Hall measure on this dg. But to fix the measure on f, I fix a character on f, and I choose the self-dual Hall measure with respect to this character. Where p is some fixed non-trivial character on f. Of course, we have to choose a Chevalier basis, but it turns out that this dg doesn't depend on the choice of Chevalier basis. And actually, it depends only on this character. So now I have fixed the Hall measure on g, which gives me a normalization of this, the formal degree d pi. Actually, so this d pi depends on pi and also this psi. Okay. And this is called formal degree. And in a joint work with Hiraga and Ikeda, so we were able to make a conjecture formula of this formal degree in terms of the Lagrange parameter. So let me explain this. Okay. Of course, the local Lagrange correspondence is still conjectural for general G, but It has been proved for many cases like GLN or classical rules. Anyhow, so let me recall what is the local Langlands correspondence. So this gives me a partition of the set of representation. And partition into a finite set called L packets. And phi runs over the set of L parameters. And inside of this, so I have a subset of square integral representations. Square integral. And on this side, so which corresponds to the L packet, we have whose L parameter is square integral. Of course, this is conjectural in general. So phi is just L parameter of G, which is some certain homomorphism from the Bayesian group to the complex dual of G, satisfying some conditions. So this is a Bayes group. And this is a dual group of G. Of course, strictly speaking, so I have to consider the G hat conjugacy class of L parameters. And the parameter corresponding to square integral representation is given by the following condition. So I say that phi is square integral if the natural object coming from phi is the centralized of this phi, centralizer or in G hat of the image of phi. And we know that this is reductive but not necessarily connected. But the condition is that this is a finite group. And so this partition is the first part of the local Langlands correspondence. But moreover, so we should have an internal structure of each L packet, which is parameterized by this component, this centralizer. So moreover, so we expect that this L packet is parameterized by the set of irreducible representations of the component group of this centralizer mod the center of G hat. And I write this map send pi to rho pi, satisfying some character relation. So one of them is the stability of the stability. So, which meaning that the weighted sum of the character is a stable distribution. And moreover, so we require that this some signed sum of this character satisfies some endoscopic character relation. Okay, so that is what I want to assume. And in the case of GLN or classical group, in the case of GLN, so this is proved by Harrison Taylor and Enyar and Schultz. And in the case of classical group, so it has been proved by Arthur in the Arthur book. So, and several years ago, so I and Hiragana Ikeda formulated a conjecture which expressed this formal degree in terms of L parameters on this low pi. So it said that the formal degree with respect to the measure determinant this psi is take an inverse is equal to here. So I need the size of centralizer. And also the representation of the component group attached to each representation. Okay. And so an adjoint gamma factor attached to the L parameter of pi. And because the formal degree is positive, so I want to put a complex absolute value of this gamma factor for all pi in the bucket and phi is squared. Well, so I need to explain this out and this gamma. Psi right hand side, psi, and the psi also appear on the left hand side. Okay. So add is the adjoint representation of G hat. And gamma is a local component of the global function equation. And so gamma is just a product of epsilon and L. Yes, and we know that it doesn't have a pole because phi is going to mention. Okay, so that is a conjecture. So let me give some remark on this conjecture. Yes, it depends on some. For example, it depends on the choice of Whittaker data. It doesn't affect the conjecture, I suppose. dimension of law shouldn't depend on this choice. This, you mean this absolute value? I need, sometimes I need absolute values. Of course, so it's, of course we want to limit this absolute value and put some extra sign. And this is what Gross and Leader did. So they compute the sign of this Ajonikam factor. Okay, so let me give some remarks. And of course, the conjecture makes sense even when F is the real field. And so this is, and actually this follows from the work of Harishchandra. I mean, so he computed the formal degree explicitly, and it is possible to compute the formal, the gamma factors at, for if F is R explicitly, so we just compare them. And of course, to make sense of the conjecture, so we need local Langlands correspondence. And the first case of the local Langlands correspondence for periodic field is the case of GLN. By Hiestera and Schultz. And in this case, we also know the conjecture holds. And actually, we have three proofs. I think they are independent. Mm-hmm. So, one is the explicit formula of the formal degree by Silver and Singh. And we can also prove this conjecture by using Langlands-Shahidi method. And we also have a proof which uses the Rankine-Selberg method of Jacques Pierre-Schleicher. JPSS. So because there are three proofs, so I'm sure that the conjecture is all okay. Okay, so now I can state our main result, but there are several other cases. And before stating the main result, maybe you might ask what this conjecture is good for. And actually, so Gross and Leader has nice application of this conjecture. Application to some explicit local Langlands correspondence. Which means the following. So suppose that pi is kind of explicitly construct, say, some compact induction. Then it is quite easy to compute the formal degree. And if you are able to compute this gamma factor, then so this means that so there is some constraint on the L parameter attached to this representation. So conjecture gives us some constraint on the L parameter attached to some explicit pi. And actually, so I've heard that this is how Grossman Leader found the simple supercapacitor representation. Application means that to finding an L parameter attached to pi. Well, so gross leader did it for, I forgot, maybe simply connected and split over F, but for any. Also, yes, I think, yes, N. Oh, this is just a candidate. So they don't prove the stability or character relation. What do you mean, particular supercapacitors? Particular supercapacitors have very sharp, not so ramified, very tamely ramified. And the main result in my talk is the following. Because we know the local Lagrange correspondence by Arthur, so the conjecture makes sense. And we for classicals, local Lagrange correspondence makes sense. And we prove the conjecture for SO2 n plus 1. Okay. So that's our main result. So, is there any question? So, I need this to be odd. Yes, of course. I still have 25 minutes to explain why. Okay, any questions so far? Okay, so let me explain the idea of the proof. Well, there are several reactions. The first reaction is to the reaction to the case of generic representations. So we know the Shahidi's generic packet conjecture in the case of SO2 n plus 1. Saying that so every tempered L packet contains a unique generic member. Generic means that the representation which has the Whittaker modulus. And so we are assuming the characterization of the L packet and which guarantees that the formal degree in a given L packet is all the same. These two things reduce the proof to the case of generic representation, and this is actually what we proved. And let me rephrase the main theorem again in the case of generic representations. Okay. Okay, suppose that sigma is a generic representation of SO 2n plus 1. The square integral and generic SO 2n plus 1. Then, so by functorality, we have a lift of sigma to GL2n. And so this, which is a tempered representation of the following form. And actually, so this has been constructed before Arthur. I mean, so this has been constructed by using Combach theorem or the method of descent. No, Combach theorem. And actually, so this lift is, I guess, due to Jahn Sudi in the case of generic representation. Where the inducing data is given by the following. And all components is on an even GL2n and square integral. And of course, so because sigma is square integral, so they must be distinct. And all symplectic, meaning that the L of pi exterior square has a pole at S is zero. And in this case, we proved that the formal degree, the inverse of the formal degree of sigma is equal to 2 to the k, which should be the size of component groups, and k appears here, times gamma of 1 of the symmetric square of pi, and pi is now GL2n representation. I don't put absolute value here because we know it's positive by the ring. And so this, so this is equal to the adjoint gamma factor of sigma by functorality. Proof in the global theory. But I think I can explain the local part of the proof in my talk. Anyhow. Okay, so how can I prove this theorem? Well, so let me write some diagram. Say that again. So check it. So the Shahidi conjecture and this uniformity of formal degree leads to the case of generic representation. So if we know the generic conjecture for the generic representation, and we know that formal degree is uniform in a given L packet. So first we proved. First, I proved this first. This uses the Arthur's character relations. Arthur, this is Arthur. Shahidi. I think it also uses Arthur because I think the comparison of the stable character and the twisted character of GL2A to ensure there is a genetic member. It's the same. It's the same for SO2N plus 1. I'm not social in the other classical groups. Okay. So let me write some diagram. So I have SO2N plus 1 representations. And I have the image of functor lift, which I write a reduce of MSQR of GL2N. This is just the image of lift. And because I lift to the set of generic representation, so this is a bijection. We know that this is a bijection. Oh, two is too small. Thank you. So this is. And to compute the formal degree, so I need some explicit model of the representation. So I want to go back. But unfortunately, the local theory is not complete for SO2N plus 1. But on the other hand, so we can go from GL2N to SP2N tilde. Generic square integral, generic of SP2N tilde. So this is due to the descent. This is the theory of descent of Ginzburg-Gray-Sudley. Ginzburg-Gray-Sudley. And I write D of psi inverse. It depends on the source. Psi inverse. And we have SO2N plus representation, SP2N tilde representation, and they are related by the theta correspondence. And so this correspondence, in this case, so this theta is studied by Wittig-Gahn Sabin. And we know that this diagonal commutes. And all arrows are bijection in this diagram. And also, we know that this bijection preserves the gamma factors, epsilon factors, and L factors for pairs. And so we want to prove the conjecture for this side. But we know that the theta correspondence preserves the formal degrees. So this means that it remains to prove the conjecture, some analogous conjecture for this group. And the good point to consider this group is that we have an explicit construction of representation by descent. So finally, so so to explain the main point of the proof, so I need to explain the GRS descent construction. So now I'd like to start from the GL2N representation, which is a image of functor lift. So I need some model, and because this is DL2N, so I have a Whittaker model. So this is temporal representation. What they do is to induce it up to SP4N, then take the Fourier Jacobi model. SP4N from the Jigel parabolic of this. I mean, so this is some representation of SP4N having a nice model. And we can also twist this pi by the we have also the determinant twist of pi. So I want to consider this induced twist by, so this is induced from pi twist to the determinant twist. Then I have an intertwining operator sending s to minus s. This is also explicit. And so now I want to consider the Fourier-Jacobi model of this induced representation. And for that, I need a Bayes representation of SP2N tilde, which is on the Schwarz function on F to the N. The product of Heisenberg group and the SP2N. Then GLS constructs the explicit integral transform of the Fourier-Jacobi model. S, which has a parameter S. So this is some induced on SP4N. And I need a Bayes representation. And from a pair of these elements, so they define some function, some Whittaker function on SP2N tilde by an explicit integral transform. So this is. And if you take that Fourier-Jacobi coefficient of the Langlands coefficient, at s is half, then you get some square integral irreducible representation of SP2N tilde. So to get the Langlands coefficient, so first I apply the intertwining operator at half of this induced. Then take that this transform at s is minus half. So this is, of course, this is a subspace of this function space. So group acts on it by left-right translation. And it turns out that this is irreducible square integral representation. N tilde is the maximum unit, the product of maximum unipotent of SP2N. Oh, psi is some. N tilde is the maximum unipotent. N tilde is the maximum potent of SP2N tilde. rather it's a pullback to SP2. The covering. This is a space of Whittaker functions. Kind of Whittaker. Okay. And so by using this explicit construction, so we compute the formal degree. And but I need one more input, which is the pairing. I need an explicit pairing to compute the formal degree. And this is given by the local zeta integral of GRS. So I change the notation a little bit. Now I put pi to that to be d of psi inverse of pi. Of course, because this is just a function, so this is a subspace of function space. So there is an obvious pairing, which is just an integration over this quotient. But we need another pairing coming from the zeta integral. So delta integral is a functional on the Whittaker model of pi tilde tensor this induced. And the Bayer representation. It is just given by so there are three variables, but simply this is the integration of W tilde against this Frege-Jacobi coefficient of induced. Okay. And so GRS constant this integral representation to get the function of pair for pairs of SP to integral representation and GL representation. And in this case, the local functional equation is of the following form. So, because so I want to switch S to minus S, and I have a intertwining plate, so I use this. The local functional equation says that J of minus S of W tilde M S phi is equal to this thing up to some gamma factors. And in this case, gamma factor is given by the following. So, so there is some denominator coming from induced representation. And in the numerator, I have 2s here. This 2 is quite important. And js. So that is the function equation. And by using this functional equation, I can define pairing. Well, so I pick a pair of elements. W tilde here and W tilde prime here. But this is the image of descent, so I can write it as the Frege-Jacobi coefficient of induced. So write this, let me write this as A of minus half of some W and phi. And so I'll send up this pair to J of half, not minus half, of W tilde, and I have W phi here, so W. But by using this function equation, so this j half can be read to the value of j of minus half up to some nominal constant. With some intertwining operator here. But by definition of that J integral, so this is just the integration of W tilde against this A integral at minus half. So maybe I think you can see it. Anyhow, so it means that this J half does depend on the choice of this W and phi. Yeah, so this is another construction of the pairing. And so by using this pairing and this explicit construction of the representation, we just compute the formal degree by using Schur orthogonality relation. Because I don't have enough time, so let me give an upshot. So some routine computation by using this plus this functional equation, and we need one more input. Gives us that this the formal degree of inverse of the formal degree is the value of the factor appearing in the function equation at half. So this part comes from the function equation. And key input. Oh, I'm sorry. Yes. Thank you. So this part comes from the function equation, and the key input gives us epsilon factor at half. And because pi is self-dual, so pi is self-dual, so this cancels. And so this is essentially gamma of pi cross pi, which is pi cross pi sim 2 plus pi exterior square. So this part will cancel with this. So we get gamma 1 pi sim 2 here. But what is interesting that we get power 2 here because the numerator and denominator have a pole of order k. Because pi is just a tempered representation. So this gives us power 2. And here we have 2 here. So this gives us power 2. So, okay, let me finish by giving what is my x. Because this has a pole, so both this and this has a pole of order k at s is half. This is s, this is 2s. So the key input is the main identity of Lapidus and Mann. So it says that the integral metric coefficient against the filter character so they consider this kind of integral, and on the other hand, so they also consider the product of evaluation of the Whittaker functions. And so you can think of this as a functional on the Whittaker space, and so they must satisfy, they satisfy the same equivalence, same equivalence properties. So they must be, so we know that they must be proportional by the uniqueness of Whittaker model. So, and so they prove that the constant of proportionality is that epsilon. And so they use this identity to prove the SP2N analog, SP2N to the analog of the formula for free coefficient of half integrated modular forms. Okay, that's it. Thank you very much.